Hello everyone. In this video we show how to use the OLED diagnostic jig to troubleshoot lines, bars or bad picture issues. To use the jig with no power or no picture issues, see the link to another video here and in the description of this video. When the TV shows lines, bars or a bad picture, it's difficult to determine which part is causing the issue. Is it a faulty OLED module? Or a faulty mainboard? In that case, you can use the OLED diagnostic jig. The jig is connected to the T-Con and the power board instead of the mainboard. The jig sends the power on signal and will try to activate a colored test pattern on the screen. Before using the jig, be aware that if the symptom is lines in the picture, first do a manual pixel cleaning. This may solve the issue without replacing the OLED module unnecessarily. To start pixel cleaning, go to All Settings, General, OLED Care, OLED Panel Care, Pixel Cleaning. Select Start Now. The TV will turn to standby and will run the pixel cleaning process. When the pixel cleaning is done, the TV will automatically turn on again and will show the message that pixel cleaning has been completed. This will take about 15 minutes on WebOS 22 or later models, or 1 hour on earlier models. When pixel cleaning is done, check if the issue still occurs. Also, before using the jig, make sure the issue is not caused by the FFC cables connected to the T-Con. If one of these connections is faulty, replacing other parts will not solve the issue. Unplug the power to the TV and take off the back cover. Also, unscrew and lift this bracket to check this side of the FFC cables. Inspect if there is any damage on the cables or strange substances on the pins. And make sure that the connections are aligned and fastened correctly. If needed, first fix or replace an FFC cable and then check if the issue still occurs. To connect the OLED diagnostic jig, unplug the power to the TV. Disconnect the 24-pin power connection cable from the main board and connect it to the jig. Disconnect the 41-pin VX1 cable between the T-Con and mainboard. This is to protect the mainboard. Disconnect the 51-pin VX1 cable from the mainboard and connect it to the jig. Be aware that on some 2023 and 2024 TV models, the VX1 cable is slightly smaller than the connector on the jig. In that case, instead of using the existing cable, use a 51-pin VX1 cable from an OLED C2 or OLED C3. Here you can see some part numbers of VX1 cables that you can use. You can also find these in the description of this video. You can use any of these cables, they differ in length, but the functionality is the same. We recommend that you order one of these cables and keep that cable fixed to your jig and always use that on all models instead of using the existing cable. When the jig is connected, plug in the power to the TV. The red LED on the jig should turn on. Put the TV in upright position to have a good view on the whole panel. A pattern with changing colors should be displayed. Inspect the pattern. If the issue is also visible when using the jig, the issue must be caused by the OLED module. In that case, replace the OLED module. If the issue is not visible when using the jig, the issue must be caused by a faulty mainboard. In that case, replace the mainboard. If the pattern does not appear when using the jig with one of these listed models, then also use a tweezer tool to short-circuit R32 on the T-Con board. This is how you can use the OLED diagnostic jig to troubleshoot lines, bars or bad picture issues. For any question, contact your local LG technical support.